Hello everyone and welcome to a new Warcraft 3 commentary. We're once again in the IEM Season 1 group stage, and unfortunately this is again one of the cases where replays are missing, so unfortunately I can only provide one replay of this best of 3. So this is map 2 between Hot and Humanic, with Hot currently leading with 1-0, both of the players here playing random, with you know, Humanic definitely being comfortable with all the races, and apparently Hot feeling like he's capable of taking down Humanic with off race. Also, of course, he's got somewhat of a buffer, if you will, and therefore he can theoretically afford losing one map. He's getting human here, spawning in the top left spawn position in blue, whereas Humanic is getting Night Elf, spawning in gray in the bottom right spawn position. And he's going for an early Ancient of War, no Altar yet, so a Tavern Hero by, built by Humanic. And the situation at the moment, rather simple. Humanic is out, and Hot, even if he loses here, is not for sure gonna be out, because if he loses here and Ciara beats Sunshine, then he's still going to advance, but of course by winning here he would be in the top 3 for sure, and he'd put you know, some pressure onto Ciara and Sunshine. So yeah, if he wins here, then Sunshine couldn't pass him anymore, and therefore Sunshine could only theoretically pass so Ciara, but not Hot, and therefore either Hot and Ciara or Hot and Sunshine could advance. So first footman is out, AM about to spawn for the Ukrainian, whereas first two archers about to be out for Humanic. Altar is about to finish, Moonwell is about to finish, he's got a Wisp here in the middle, so we'll see what hero choice he's going to decide to go for. First creep has gone down, Gauntlets of Ogre Strength for the Human, and the Night Elf picks up a Panda first. Pretty unique choice, especially given that this is Turtle Rock, and if the Human, you know, gets wind of the Panda first choice of the Night Elf player, then the Human usually has a pretty easy time preventing the Night Elf from getting level 3 on this particular map, and therefore especially on Turtle Rock, the Panda first in this matchup, a very very uncommon choice. But maybe Humanic can make it work. Maybe he also plans on capitalizing on the fact that Hot is not a you know, main race Human, and maybe doesn't have all of the right approaches figured out. So level 2 for the AM, Claws plus 6 for him, pretty nice, whereas the Panda slowly gonna continue creeping. Why does he have so much XP? The killer scout? No, Hot didn't even scout yet. Humanic on the other hand did scout, so I'm assuming he must have detonated a water elemental with a Wisp at some point, because only the one green camp doesn't give that much experience. Circlet and Mantle of Intelligence for the Panda, so pretty much the perfect item drops for him here so far. AM continues creeping, no fast expansion whatsoever, tech halfway done, blacksmith coming, shop coming, so we'll probably see Rifleman and casters. Plenty of archers already out for Humanic, who, as you can see, still has a long road ahead of him before reaching level 3, and he's getting his second Ancient of War. Okay, so he's obviously gonna want to use this one to creep probably up here in the second one. I'm not really sure. More archers, maybe? We'll find out if Hot is gonna let it come up even, which I guess he doesn't intend to do. So level 2 Panda means level 1 Breath of Fire, which already does decent damage against the footman. So there's only DAM here available to, you know, continue doing damage to this Ancient of War, but he's not gonna get it. The footman here trying to escape from the Panda, who luckily doesn't have Boots of Speed yet. Where's the AM? Wow, he's being blocked by the Ancient of War here, and Hot seems to not realize it, going after the footman here, but up there the footmen are doing a pretty good job blocking the Panda away, so both of the players really doing decently on one front here. All of three footmen are gonna survive, as it seems. The AM is gonna survive as well, but he's taken so much damage after being blocked by the Agent of War here. Panda second for Hot as well. So it looks like he might be playing along with the theme of picking unconventional heroes here. But then again, given the number of archers here and the fact that there is no Demon Hunter on the Night Elf side, this Panda second might not be the worst choice, but then I guess Hot should probably not be aiming for a super long-term game, because, you know, once there are many Dryads and Bears on the field, the significance and the impact of the Panda is going to decrease significantly. So I guess creeping 3-3 and then going for a push might be the best option that Hot does have at the moment. Arcane Sanctum is being power built. He's continuing to creep. The Panda reaching the level 3 here after finishing the natural expansion creep camp. When of mana seeking for him, well, it's definitely not the best item that could drop there, but it definitely has the potential to turn out very useful, since of course it provides 100 of mana potentially for Humanic, whereas it rids Hot of 100 mana. Our forces are under attack. So not quite level 3 yet for the AM Panda. 1.5, more and more archers are out, 6 already by now. Ancient of War repositioning here, and double Ancient of Lore just now coming, and no quick tier 3 tech by the Night Elf, which surprised me a little bit, but then again, he doesn't really have the lumber to even afford that at the moment. One footman gets taken down here by the Drakenhaze Breath of Fire. The archer's hiding here. Maybe he's gonna be able to surprise Hot, which I guess was his intention, but Hot is not marching in here, and therefore no, you know, for example, a quick force of a town portal of the AM. Hot pulling back, and he's gonna get the level 3 right now with his AM and some more experience on his Panda. Maybe if he pulls the AM away in time, the Panda can even reach level 2 already here. Tier 3 still not started. He invests a lot of lumber right now into Abolish Magic, as well as the first couple of Dryads. Shop is being produced. And what is Humanic doing at the moment? He doesn't really achieve anything. And it looks like with these archers and the level 3 Panda, he wants to apply a lot of pressure here. Second Arcane Sanctum coming already. Not sure if I'm a fan of that, since he's mostly going to face Dryads, which aren't exactly bad against Breakers and Casters. So two Peasants are being taken down here. Third one has to pull back. And Arcane Sanctum has finished though, so it's gonna take a long time to take that down with only archers and the Panda. And Hot is coming in from the right hand side here, pretty smart positioning. Drakenhaze Breath of Fire going onto the archers. Humanic is doing a bit of a split, really putting those archers in a vulnerable position, but he's putting them all the way back, so I guess it's fine. But this also means that he's not really going to be able to continue fighting here. One priest is about to get sniped out. Dispel on one of the water mantles. Stride has to pull back immediately though. The three archers here also surviving, so nothing lost for the Night Elf player so far. He's going to have to town portal with the Panda probably after killing this rifleman. Next Stride arrives at the fight. This Stride has also survived. Oh, and these archers miss moving, and two of them are going to die. Or are they? At least one of them is going to die. Okay, only one of them. Still, the creeps ended up getting more kills than Hot did. Our sacred grove is being desecrated. So, yeah, with a few archers here, as you can see, 1, 2, 3 corpses. And two peasants here, which is probably not going to be game deciding, but still is also not going to hurt Humanic. He did some alright damage, only losing one archer there, unfortunately, to the creeps. Panda getting all the way up to level 4. Needs to make sure not to get trapped here by the creeps, and he does make sure that that's the case, and therefore he can continue safely creeping here with the Ancient of War Invisibility Potion board. So it looks like he's gonna try and creep check here, maybe, you know, steal an item. Or is he going into the base, that would be extremely risky given the low HP he's got. But then again, there's a staff of teleportation also, so he shouldn't be in any serious trouble if he decides to reveal himself inside of the human main base. Watcher Ward dropped here, and Boots of Speed, well, I guess he can sell those, get a little bit of extra gold dependent now in the back of the base. But actually the base is closed here, so very important move here by Hot to get the tower to prevent the panda from getting into the back of the base. Of course, one huge weakness of getting the panda second for the human instead of the Mountain King is that there's virtually nothing he can do to prevent the panda from just getting into the back there and then staffing out eventually, because there's no stun, obviously. So the positioning of that tower, pretty important there. Panda just making sure that there's no counter expansion whatsoever coming. Maybe he... Oh, in the meantime, the archers, drides, and first two adept bears getting caught off guard here. Tier 3, not even done yet, so master is gonna take a while. And wow, all of the archers taking so much damage by the level 3 panda. To just quickly finish my thought, I wanted to say he could have waited for the town hall to be produced and then do the breath of fire and force the cancel, which would have cost Hot a little bit more gold. Panda stepping in. Boots should be picked up now any second, so that was quite painful. Three archers down here, thanks to the Knight of Player being caught off guard. The panda gets the last hit, actually, as well as the Greater Heal Potion. Big move by Humanic. So this one, getting him close to level 5 already, could definitely turn out very, very useful later on. Three bears on the field right now. Tier 3 has finished. Master about to finish as well for the Knight Elf. Hot slowly but surely has to push, because as this panda grows stronger and stronger, things aren't gonna get any easier for him. He's got one he square at the moment. He could pick up a second one. And look at the bank of the Night Elf. He's probably gonna have to use his heal potion here. Actually, he doesn't. Okay, now he does. I thought that wasn't really necessary, because the slow was about to, or was wearing off already, so he could have just walked out of there. So maybe a little bit of an overreaction by Humanic there, wasting his greater heal potion, which would have been so useful in upcoming fights. Second heal scroll has been bought right now, so he can creep here, you know, pick up the rune, pick up great item, get the wow, get some more experience on both of his heroes. AM is level 4 right now. We'll see what item he's gonna pick up here, and once again it is Humanic who's going to apply some pressure. Rune of Healing dropped here, as always, obviously, and he's getting Warsong Battle Drums. Wow, best item probably could have found there. So Dryads in front here, trying to take down the Arcane Tower, but the Town Portal is coming in, and therefore the damage output there is definitely not going to be enough to get rid of the tower. Panda level 4 as well, so we do have 4 heroes. AM plus 28 damage, that's insane. Against the almost level 5 Panda of Humanic, who's going to reach level 5 right now. He does have a Town Portal. He's gonna have to drop something if a good item drops here, which would probably be the case, and I'm guessing the staff, maybe? Or the mantle. We'll see. Well, whatever dropped there, he destroyed it. So it must have been quite crappy. Worse than the Mantle of Intelligence, plus 3. That's certainly interesting. More bears streaming in. Hot does have quite a huge army, though. With plenty of breakers by now. Still a lot of... Well, a decent number of riflemen. 5, that is. And a couple of casters, whereas mostly bears and a couple of dryads for Humanic, who's of course got the level 5 panda by now. It looks like he's about to get another hero. Well, just about to finish. Ancient of Wind is being added right now, but his macro is really lacking here. Pitlord second, alright, so he's really going for the fire AoE here against the casters and riflemen. Dragon Haze, Breath of Fire coming in level 5, of course, so powerful. So it's 54 against 70, 600 gold in the bank for the Knight Elf. Ancient of Wind is coming just now. No 70 supply Moonwell. This one is gonna have to be cancelled, but he doesn't cancel it in time. Bears are marching out right now. The position is perfect for the human player, as all of the breakers are blocking in front. The Bears and Drites are not at all getting any access to the casters or to the weak units. Panda in front has on the top is taking a bit of damage. Next Breath of Fire is coming in, doing a ton of damage as well, though there's still a heal scroll on the Panda of Hot, whereas Humanic doesn't have any healing left. Bear after bear is falling here for him, and Hot is standing strong here in this fight. 1-0 upgrades for him as well against 1-0 by Humanic, but the human army is just crushing the Night Death player here, who has committed to this fight in the worst possible position, who has barely killed any units. Agent of War is being taken down. Now the last heal scroll has finally gone. Panda, look at the Panda, he was at level 5 before the fight started, he barely gathered any experience. This Dragon Haze Breath of Fire hitting very nicely as the Breakers were in front there, not in the back, not securing the rest of the army against the Panda. Another Clarity has been used. Now Hot is doing a better job. Breath of Fire through the forest doesn't really hit anything significantly. And how is Humanic supposed to hold this? 33 supply, he's got somewhat close to nothing left. Another Rain of Fire could be coming in here any second, which is what he's doing right now. Panda at the top. Well, level 6 could be the saving grace here, but I guess that's not gonna happen as he's still so far away from, you know, reaching that level 6. Another two casters being taken down here. Breath of Fire into the Moongirls is going to get rid of three of them soon. And if he does so, then Humanic is even going to be supplied by Panda. Once again, getting up there to the shop. Another Moonstone used. Breath of Fire is going into the Moonwells again, and therefore three of them are falling. AM level 5 right now, so level 3 Water Elementals. And yeah, there's somewhat close to nothing left for Humanic. He still has his Panda. He still has his Pitlord, but nothing else. Pitlord also didn't really do anything. Guess a solo Panda will also not be level 6 yet. And with a solo Panda, he also would probably have lost that fight. So, very strange by him here, seeing that the human army was going to come in to commit to a fight in such a narrow position. Also on top of that, while he was able to level his Panda pretty decently, his macro was slipping so much. Like, he was supply blocked all the time, he had so much gold all the time. He also, when the fight started, he had like 600 gold in the bank. The Agent of Wind, of course, for the Fairy Dragons came way too late, so either build it early enough or don't build it at all. But like that, of course, there was no point in it. Additionally, the item drops for Hot were just crazily good with the Warsong Battle Drums, with all of the bonus damage for the AM, whereas the Panda, you know, found Wind of Mana Stealing, found whatever item he found at the Natural of Hot, which he destroyed immediately. And of course, also the waste of the big heal potion wasn't exactly great, but also not game deciding, I think, because it was never about the Panda being focused down or anything. So yeah, Hot with a decent push with a tier 2 army, taking this game here, taking the series with 2-0. As I mentioned previously, the first replay unfortunately is not available anymore, and this means that Hot is going to advance, is going to be either second or third place. At the moment, he's in front of Ciara, and Sunshine cannot surpass him anymore. So it's going to be up to Sunshine to beat Ciara with 2-0 if he wants to advance. If he beats him with 2-0, both of them, both Ciara and Sunshine, will be at 6 points at 5-5 maps. But in the direct comparison, of course, Sunshine will then be ahead and therefore be in the lead. If anything else happens, then Ciara will advance, and the only difference between Ciara winning or Ciara losing with 1-2 is going to be if Ciara loses with 1-2, he's going to be third and Hot's going to be second. And if Ciara wins, no matter with what score, then Ciara will be second and Hot will be third. So those are all the options. The pressure is definitely on Sunshine, and I hope you're looking forward to this best of three, and I hope you enjoyed this sadly only one mapper. And I'll see you soon. Bye.